Were you trained as a fighting soldier before D-Day?
I was trained as a commando, and then the course for commando training.
And how long had you been in the army for?
Oh, about 6 years, till the end of the war.
And how old were you when you first set off for the beaches in Normandy?
21 years of age.
How did your family feel about you going off to war?
Well, they didn't know. I didn't tell them I was going abroad. At first they knew about it, seen the papers and newspapers.
On D-Day, when you left England for Normandy, did you have any idea what you would be facing when you arrived?
When you were going to the second front, we didn't know where. They kept that secret from us.
How bad was the crossing over the boat?
Terrible. I was sick the whole way across. And I was sick before it was sailed. I ran to my doctor and said, I did fit any amount of Germans get off the boat. The engine to get off the boat.
What were the thoughts and feelings as the ramp lowered as you arrived at the beach?
Well, there was two ramps on the line craft. Lord loved it, my boss, jumped off first. Well, I didn't know how deep the water was, so wait till he went in. And then the nurse chap took his place in the ramp, and he was killed immediately. And that made me hurry up.
What were the sights and sounds hit you as you left the landing craft?
Well, there was a lot of noise of burning tanks on the beach, and people shouting behind the tanks. There's a lot of noise.
Did your commander then ask you to play while walking up and down the beach, or was it at your own suggestion?
It was my own suggestion. As I came off the landing craft, I started to play about in the water and surf. But the lover asked me to play pipes and boat in the shore.
What thoughts were going through your mind while such in a dangerous situation?
Oh, strange enough, all I was concerned about was the pipes all right, which is tuned properly.
And can you describe what you saw?
Well, we came out, they said in England, if you get off the beach as quick as possible, but we held for 2 minutes, and a dozen chap wounded, where the medic, it won't be long. But go off to be letters.
Were you afraid about being injured or shot?
No. I didn't think about no cook. I thought an ordinary soldier, everyone else would get hit, except me. At this time, it was right enough. I wasn't with it.
How long did it take from landing to be able to leave the beach?
Oh, it seemed like ages, but we had to get off the beach quick, because the Germans were shelling the beach. And mortar, we could see mortar come overhead, so we were off pretty quick.
What did the other men say to you about what you've just done?
Well, when I was playing the pipes, a shout came up to me. I recognised them as a Royal Marine sergeant. And I said, what are you playing, you bloody mad bastard? And I didn't know what pushed off and just kept on playing. But he was the only critic I had.
Can you describe the sense of relief when you were off the beach and safe?
Well, we come off the beach, it was people sleeping at us for quite some time. So I was more dangerous as we heading inland. I get heavier.
You then went on to cross Pegasus Bridge. While under fire, can you describe what happened?
We crossed Pegasus Bridge and then we crossed Randall Bridge. As we approached the bridge, I could see across. I could see two airborne shots trying to shut me up. And I turned around and looked at Lowe and he says, "Cut on." And I crossed the bridge. It was the longest bridge I ever crossed. But I got across safely and shook hands with two airborne lads. Then Lowe came over.
What was the reaction of the troops when you arrived at the other side of the bridge?
It was an airborne officer came from across the road and held his hand out to Lord Lovett and said, "If any police will see you, boy." And Lovett said, "I fear police will see you, boy."
Can you say how you felt afterwards to have played a part in such a famous day in history?
Well, I was only one in the whole invasion who went ashore with their kilts and unarmed and played the bagpipes. So nobody else had done that. Of course, I was only 21 at the time.
Did you ever have to pick up a weapon and fire in anger?
Later on, I had to. Later on, we went with old Pegasus Bridge and we had dug in.
How long were you in France for after D-Day?
3 months in France. That was the longest time of any soldier having to be in action. For 3 months in action.
How did you feel when you finally returned home?
We were on a tight landing craft to come back, and we landed at Southampton. And it was seemed strange hearing English voices and the people about the place. It was unreal.
When did you leave the army?
In 1946.
And what did you do after the war?
Well, I'm doing a bit in the timber that had trees in the forge, the tree chopping down trees. But I didn't like that, but it was long, very quiet. I wanted some excitement, so I shot advertising for a paper to go on the stage. So on the stage for about 10 months, two of them, England, Ireland, Wales, Scotland.
How long have you lived in Dawlish for?
I hear 46 years. 46.
What attracted you to the area?
I was here in the wartime. We used to march from Plymouth right through Dawlish and across Lumpson. So I knew Dawlish pretty well. It's a quiet place, isn't it?
Are you still able to attend any reunions or take part in memorial services?
Yes, well, the friends invited me over last year. Took a nurse to with me to look after me. And we had a long weekend there and a $10 ceremonies. And once I've been to Paris.
Do people still show interest in your past experience?
Well, it is alive now as it ever was, strangely enough. People seem to be fascinated about the idea of a young man dressed in a kilt going into battle.
Do you ever have any regrets about anything that happened to you during your time spent in Normandy?
No, I enjoyed it. It was sad the time we get killed and things, but I was never wounded, so I really looked on as an adventure. I enjoyed that, yeah.
Thanks for answering the question. We're finished with that now.
That's all right.
Do you think that your playing really helped the troops?
I think so. It's even about the noise. It's a healing about it.